Welcome to another J Crazy News Headlines and a special Tuesday to those watching this news broadcast. Now to my viewers and my subscribers. Them always say no. Sorry for MAGA dog. Let's see a MAGA dog. Turn one. Bite you. And it's not every fan member or relative you should help, because some of them are real demons. Now, key right now is Susie Taylor, her husband, and her two children, who were fatally stabbed by a relative, nephew of the grandmother, which took place on Sunday in Far Rockaway, Queens, New York. Now, the Jamaican family of four did not survive the attack. However, the grandmother survived, but she was badly injured during the attack. Now, the suspect, whose name is Courtney Garden, who you see on your screen right now. Now, Courtney Garden was shot by a police officer after he injured two police officers. Now, this youth killed his relatives plus injured two cops. That's a death wish, not to mention injuring his grandmother, who gracefully took him in after he went homeless, to be exact. Christine Watson, who is of 61 years of age, is in hospital fighting for her life, all because her nephew, the suspect, the killer, who was Courtney God, age 38, went on a stabbing spree. Miss Christine Watson extended a kind-hearted invitation to her homeless nephew, who was Courtney God. But unfortunately, her kindness didn't matter, because he made a bloody scene in that home, killing four family and badly injuring the grandmother, who is the mother of Suzette Taylor. Now, I said before, Suzette Taylor, her husband and her two children are now dead. But the grandmother, who is the mother, again I say, of Suzette Taylor, is battling for her life in hospital. Now, she was found by responders in critical condition and rushed to the hospital from the home where the attacker, the suspect, did the crime. Not only that, he also lit a couch in the house. Now, on Thanksgiving, to be exact, which was last month, the family grew increasingly fearful of Garden and told him that he had to move out of the home. Now, this was told by a friend of the family. Now, the first person who Garden killed was a son-in-law, which was Suzette Taylor's husband, who them called Davis. Now, Davis is said to be allegedly from Clarendon. However, it hasn't been 6 months good. He has gone overseas, and our friends are more lost of him being brutally murdered by the suspect who was killed, who was the nephew of Miss Christine Watson. Charmaine Taylor revealed that the family had to begin suspecting George may fly off the handle, and had spoken of what to do in case of domestic emergency. So basically, he was in preparation to commit the act. Now, inside the home, Watson's teenage daughter followed the plan on Sunday, broke a window to get out of the house and call 911. Then the teen had run through the window. Charmaine Taylor said They thought for a long time that he might do something like this. He was talking strange things. He was acting strange. Which means that the family suspects say he is having devious and evil thoughts of committing a horrible act towards them, which could or did take their life. Unfortunately, on Sunday to be exact, the monster, after doing a pre-preparation in thoughts and planning the attack, he put that thought and planning into action. Now, the husband and his son, which was Christine's grandson and also son-in-law, they recently moved from Jamaica and they came to live in the home that she lives in. However, the family is devastated. They're in shock as to what could have taken place, as to why he did this. They're even questioning if he had a mental illness. Now, I don't believe that Courtney Garden had a mental illness. I believe he was just plain old demon, plain old wicked. And we need to actually stop bringing mental illness in line with a cold-blooded killer. Garden was a cold-blooded killer. He pre-planned his killing in his thoughts. He knew what he was doing, and he committed the horrible act of killing 4 family members, the mother, the father, and the 2 children, and also badly injuring his grandmother, who is now in hospital battling for her life. As I said before, it's not a relative you see, you must extend your hand to. I said before, Seraphim Magadog, Magadog will turn around and bite you. Had they knew this about Gardner, I'm pretty sure Christine Watson would not send an invitation or warm, kind-hearted gesture of inviting Gardner to live among them. I said before, he could have been going through certain things, not making excuses for his action he did. However, he could have been living a life, you know, in the streets that was violent. And that could have led him to be homeless. Or because of his life choices that went wrong, he developed anger. However, this is no excuse for what he did to the family. And now he's dead as well. He took 4 family members, injuring his grandmother, 2 other cops, and now he is in the mark, as well as the 4 other family members. This is very, very sad. And honestly, personally, I don't know what's going on in America when it comes to Jamaicans. Over the few years, I've seen Jamaicans being killed brutally in different states in America, especially in New York. What's really going on? It's like it's a demonic attack on Jamaicans in Jamaica and also overseas. Something is seriously wrong. However, to the family, condolences. This is Jay Crazy again. Until then, have a blessed and safe Tuesday.
Yeah man, I'm here to see a black legend. I'm here to represent for J Crazy YouTube reviewing channel. So watch, like, comment, subscribe and share out the thing. J Crazy YouTube reviewing channel. In review news and entertainment. Celebrity lifestyle movements as well. J Crazy not playing in my review the thing then. J Crazy YouTube reviewing channel. In review news and entertainment. Celebrity lifestyle movements as well. J Crazy not playing in my review the thing then. Review the thing then, review the thing then. J Crazy reviewing news, entertainment and celebrity lifestyle. Review the thing then, review the thing then. J Crazy.